today I just returned from working with the teams on the field in a slum, and I met a mother who just told me, a mother of six, who just told me that she will probably die of hunger before she would die of COVID. This is how bad she feels the situation. All the families we talk to, all of them report a loss of income of 60 to 80% or even more. It's getting so difficult that, for example, this mother, in order to survive, she went to get a loan. And in order to reimburse the loan, she's getting more loans and more loans. And so she's getting deeper and deeper in debt with no way out. She's currently over $500 in debt, which is enormous for slum families. And we see an increase in very unsafe behaviors. We see more kids coming to work. We have seen an increase of women coming into prostitution. We also worry a lot about the education of children, because what happens is that the schools are closed, so they have been out of school for a very long time, and remote education is not really an option. And we are very worried that many, many of these children will not be able to come back to school because they won't be able to afford it. So this is where the Friends International teams come in. The first thing we do always is the assessment of the families to make sure and understand what they need, and then provide emergency support so they can remain afloat, they can feed themselves, and the children are safe. We also make sure and support them to find a job or be able to maintain their income, which is essential. We also support education of children. We have organized a system where the kids can call us for support, and so we distribute hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of homework every day to the children in those different communities. Over the past years, we were able to build a community volunteer network, the Child Safe Agents. And they are based in those communities. We work through them, and they have access to those people. They distribute the homework. They give us information about the families, and this allows us to continue the support to the children, to the families, even when we cannot go. And they are really, truly everyday heroes. Thank you.